King Dinosaur, a 1955 U.S. one-sheet movie poster, linen-backed. The folds it had have been flattened. Watch how we did it.
Machine folded originally, like this, sharp creases. These creases will, and rips, and there's also a break in here. And this will all get put together when it's linen-backed. King Dinosaur is going to get wheat paste directly onto it.
The kind of paper that movie posters of the 1950s is made of, or are printed on, is very good for linen backing. It absorbs the wheat paste very well. It's very porous and agreeable, and the inks are always stable. The poster expands well once the wheat paste is applied. The image make for an interesting poster. The artwork is fun, even though the dinosaur's authenticity is questionable.
That is not a proper dinosaur.
King Dinosaur. Well, let's see. This movie is, let's say it's a bit tacky. It's one of those, from 1955, one of those monster movies. It's about a new planet that enters our solar system. And four scientists, made up of two couples, venture to that planet to explore it. And when they get there, they find it looks remarkably like Earth, and it's inhabited by various creatures, monsters, so to speak. Most of them are like things you see on Earth, except they're enlarged armadillos and reptiles and various creatures like that. It's the sort of movie that any science teacher would cringe about knowing that her students might be watching it on the weekend because it's not real good science. It's the sort of movies they made in the 50s.
Seriously.
We are washing off the poster to make sure all the excess wheat paste has been removed and that it's clean. This will also help take off any surface dirt that might be in the poster. The astronauts in this movie are more on a camping trip than investigating a new planet. The two men are, you know, macho, and the two women scream a lot. The so-called special effects were bad even in 1955 and are just laughable today. Actually, kind of fun to watch if you're at a college party and you're drinking. The main attraction to this movie is the humor you can find in it. The only entertainment value I found with this film was seeing how naive the characters were and how badly done the dinosaurs were. Oddly enough, this movie is so bad, it's worth watching.
Seriously?
My son is 10 years old. He's accustomed to watching movies like Jurassic Park, where the animation is quite developed, let's say. I'm not sure he could watch this movie. On the other hand, he likes to see variations of dinosaurs and the different ways that things are presented in history, so maybe he would have an open mind. I don't know. I don't think he would buy this dinosaur, though.
We're gonna let King Dinosaur dry for a few days before we trim it down. It doesn't need very much touch-up, but just a little bit in the...
Sorry to interrupt this video. I am a dinosaur expert. And this is not a bona fide dinosaur. It's not a real dinosaur that ever existed. This might look like a mix of a Spinosaurus or a T-Rex. Has some elements of the Spinosaurus and some of the T-Rex. It also looks like the Japanese monster Godzilla. But this is not a Japanese movie. If you have any other opinions about this that you don't agree with me, then please let me know in the comment section below. Peace out.
The poster doesn't need very much in terms of restoration. All I need to do is restore the color that's missing in the folio fold lines. And for that, I'm going to use watercolor pencils and watercolor markers, both of which are water reversible and archival.
I've got a new reflection, severed forever and always upon.
Poster Fix.